So welcome to the Agriculture channel. Okay, so please, if you are liking the channel, please like it and subscribe it. Okay, so we have already covered the denitrification, sorry, leaching loss of nitrogen. So now let us move the second law, second process, which is the volatilization loss, of nitrogen. Here we will see different form of volatilization loss of the nitrogen. Okay, so first of all, we have already studied the first important thing we have to write in the exam is that what will be the condition. The condition will be always remember, this will be the alkaline condition, first one, and another is calcareous soil. Two conditions should be there, one is alkaline soil and another is it should be calcareous soil. And as we have already known, the loss will be about 5 to 35% loss will be there due to the volatilization loss will be there. Okay. So here we will see different forms of loss or how the volatilization loss will be occur in case of alkaline soil and calcareous soil. So first of all, you just remember, if I am applying first to the reaction, you just remember, if I am applying the ammonical form of fertilizer, that is NH4O2SO4, this is ammonium sulfate, whenever I am applying ammonium sulfate, then as it is calcareous soil, so it will react with calcium carbonate, yes or no? Again it will react with water. Remember, ammonium sulfate will be there, then it will react with calcium carbonate and water. Now it will release. This is the volatilization process, and after reaction of the ammonium sulfate with calcium carbonate, now it will release NH4+, this will be released NH4+, 2NH4+, then it will release calcium will be released, then OH- will be released, then another calcium sulfate will be released, CaSO4. Okay, and if we will balance the equation, then always remember, as you know, whenever ammonium fertilizer will be there, then another will be the HCO3- will be reached. Okay? So if we will balance the equation, then here we will multiply 2, then here we also will multiply 2, then 2 calcium will be there. Now 2HCO3 will be also released, 2NH4+, and 2HCO3 will be also released. And calcium ion will be there, OH minus will be there. Okay? So now here we will see, as OH minus ion will be released, so the pH will increase. Yes or no? Again, you just remember, this NH4+ and HCO3-, these both ions will react with each other to release ammonium gas and water and carbon dioxide. Okay, you just remember, this ammonia, this is has the dilution effect. Which effect? Dilution effect. Or we can say this NH4+ has the dilution effect. So whatever the ammonia gas is there, this is aqueous ammonia, this is aqueous form of ammonia, yes or no? Now this, that means this is soluble in nature, this form is dilution effect is there, so soluble in nature. But here this also has salt, calcium sulfate is a salt, but it is sparingly soluble. Remember, it is sparingly soluble. Okay. So what do you mean by sparingly soluble? It is less soluble in nature as compared to the ammonical form of ion, because it has the dilution effect. So whatever the ammonia gas will be there, it is the aqueous form of the ammonia. Aqueous means water is there, so the term is aqueous. Aqueous form of ammonia will be there. Okay. So now you just remember, I am telling a story to you. Okay. So we have two students are here. Let us take two students example. One is Bisho and another is Satya. They are visiting to a marketplace. They are going to a market, and Bisho has 100 rupees. Satya has also 100 rupees. Yes or no? So now Bisho want to purchase dress. Bisho want to purchase a dress which amounts to 80 rupees, and he will eat from the restaurant. Yes or no? So Bisho will purchase the dress whose cost is 80 rupees, and he will eat whose cost is 20 rupees. But now Satya will purchase a dress whose cost is 20 rupees, but he will eat whose cost is 80 rupees. That means Bisho likes to purchase dresses. Means Bisho likes shopping, whereas Satya likes eating. So based on their choices, Bisho spend more rupees on dress and less rupees for eating purpose, whereas Satya spends more rupees for eating purpose and less rupees for shopping purpose. Yes or no? What will be the constant? The constant is that whatever the amount they have, both have similar amounts, but the difference is now he is spending more rupees in dress, but he is spending less rupees in dress. So we have to compromise. If you want to purchase dress, then you have to compromise the food. You have to compromise the food. Yes or no? If I want to spend more on shopping, that means I should compromise in eating. Otherwise, if I want to spend more rupees for eating purpose, that means I have to compromise for shopping purpose. So these are the things we should know. Okay. So basically, you should know that here two things are there. Likewise, you think here this NH3 what here you have 1 liter of solution. You have 1 liter of water. We can say water. We can say this is okay. Let us. We have 1 liter water. 1 liter water. So now in this water, now ammonia want to dilute. As in now the fixed, this is 1 liter is fixed. Within this 1 liter, ammonia want to solubilize. Yes or not? Ammonia want to solubilize as well. As this is sparingly soluble, hence it also wants to solubilize. Yes or no? So now the amount of water is fixed. This is 1 liter. Again, in this 1 liter, this NH has the NH4 plus has the dilution effect. So this NH3 want to mix as well as this calcium sulfate is also want to mix. But the condition is that is this calcium sulfate is sparingly soluble, means now the amount of NH3 aqueous will be more, whereas amount of CaSO4 soluble will be less. Yes or no? Remember, as it is sparingly soluble, so in the solution the portion of the calcium sulfate will be less, but in case of ammonical form it will be more. Okay. Again, Now you just remember what I told you. What I have called here, in this case, in the solution, the NH3 aqueous proportion will be more in this situation. Whereas calcium sulfate in the solution, it will be less. Yes or no? Again, now for volatile solvent, you just remember, for volatile solvent, it is nothing but that diffusion process. Yes or no? It is nothing but the diffusion process. And in this diffusion process, always the partial pressure of NH3 should be more important. NH3 in aqueous medium should be more than the partial pressure of NH3 in the atmosphere. Yes or no? Because you know, if this is the soil, this is the atmosphere. Now whatever the NH3 will be there in the aqueous solution, it will volatile solution means it will move from the soil to the atmosphere. Volatile means whatever the ammonia will be produced, it will move from the soil to the atmosphere. Yes or no? So when it will move, if the partial pressure of ammonia in the soil is more than the partial pressure of the ammonia for the atmosphere, if it is more, then it will move away. Yes or no?
Yes.
In this situation, the aqueous ammonia concentration will be more. Okay. So now take another example. In this case, you remember, this calcium sulfate is sparing its salt. Okay. So now, if I will take another example, let us say I am taking ammonium nitrate. In this case, ammonium sulfate is a fertilizer. Here I am taking ammonium nitrate. It will again react with calcium carbonate and water. Yes or no? And it will release, say, NH4+, plus HCO3-, plus calcium, plus OH-, and calcium nitrate will be provided. And calcium nitrate will be produced. And remember, this calcium nitrate, this is soluble in water. Yes or no? In this case, it is sparingly soluble. Or we can say less soluble. Okay, if we are applying ammonium sulfate, then here calcium sulfate is sparingly soluble. Hence, the concentration of calcium sulfate in the solution is less as compared to ammonia. But in this case, now calcium nitrate is soluble, whereas this NH4+ is also soluble. So there will be competition between NH4+ and calcium nitrate for the solubility, because this NH4+ which will release the NH3 gas, because we know these both will release NH3 gas. So there will be competition between the NH4 or NH3 dilution effect as well as the solubility of the calcium nitrate. So as there will be competition, so here the NH3 aqueous will be less. Yes or no? Whereas calcium nitrate will be more. In solution, the NH3 amount will be less, and in solution, the calcium nitrate amount will be more, because this is more soluble in water. Hence, the concentration of the solution will be more. But as I have told, the amount of water is fixed. So, if it is more, then NH3 will be less. Okay. So, in case of minimizing the volatilization loss, this fertilizer, source of the fertilizer should be more important. If you are applying any fertilizer like ammonium sulfate, which will release the sparingly soluble salt, that means the partial pressure of the NH3 will be more. So in case of partial pressure of NH3 will be more, so your monetization loss will be more. But if we are applying this ammonium form of fertilizer, if we are applying ammonium form of fertilizer, so the partial pressure of the NH3 case will be less. So we can say volatilization loss will be less, or we can minimize the volatilization loss. Okay. So if we will arrange this fertilizer in a order, then here this will be the order. Here this will be the NH4HCO3. Then it will be, we can say, then here it will be ammonium sulfate. Then it will be urea, then it will be ammonium nitrate. So more volatilization loss will be here, then here, then here. It is less volatilization loss will be there in case of NH3, NH4, ammonium nitrate. Okay, so this is the volatilization loss will be there. Again, okay, you just check it out. What are the reactions of what I have told? Okay. So next. Next we will see. As we have seen, here we can see that as these reactions are occurring, so pH will increase. Okay. So you remember, if the pH will increase, as we have already told, in alkaline soil, the volatilization loss will be more. So you just remember, if the pH will be more, then volatilization loss will be more. Yes or no? Second thing, you just think here. Now NH4 will react with the HCO3, what I told, then it will release NH3, yes or no? But you think, if the soil has high cation excess capacity, then ammonium fixation will be there, so then volatilization loss will be there, yes or no? That means if the soil has high CEC, then NH4 fixation will be there. That means NH3 production will be decreased. That means volatilization loss will be decreased. That means here if the pH will increase, then volatilization loss will be increased. If the soil has less cation excess capacity, then also volatilization loss will be increased. Because if it has less cation excess capacity, that means NH4 fixation will be not there. Because it is a low cation excess capacity, so NH4 fixation will be not occurring. Hence, most of the NH4 loss will reach NH3, so volatilization loss will be 1. Okay, so here we can see, here we just remember, what are the concentration of the NH3 plus aqueous, and here is the pH. If the pH it is 5, 7, 9, then what will be the proportion, what will be the percentage of the NH3 in the solution? And as we know, if we are increasing the pH, that means 5, 7, then 9. Increasing the pH, that means the ammonia concentration will be more. Here it is 0.00316%. Okay? 0.00. So now, you just remember 0.316%, then 31.6%. Okay? That means here you can see, if we are increasing the pH by 2 units, yes or no? If we are increasing the pH by 2 units, now the percentage will increase 100-fold, yes or no? Means if I will increase the pH 2 unit, that means NH3 aqueous concentration will increase 100 unit. So if I will increase 1 unit, then it will be 10 times of increase, or 10 fold will be there. Okay, so this is the basic things whatever we have done. Okay, just remember these things. So this is up to 9 pH. Okay. So if the pH will increase, the vibration also will increase. So okay, next thing will be there. For minimization of the loss, we have already told. For minimizing the loss, for minimizing the loss, if I want to minimize, I have already told, if you have urea, then do not mix with soil if it is alkaline. Okay, because vibration loss will be there. Okay, so second thing, this is the first one. We have told the source of fertilizer. Second, we have to remember that whatever the vibration loss will be there, this is because of the diffusion process. So as you know, this diffusion process is increased if the temperature will increase. So if you want to minimize the vibration loss, we have to minimize the diffusion process, so that we have to maintain the soil temperature. We have to minimize the soil temperature. Yes or no? Again, if you want to minimize the vibration loss, so I want to increase the cation exchange capacity of the soil, or we can say we want to increase the buffering capacity of the soil. And this buffering capacity is by means of organic matter. If we will add organic matter, then the buffering capacity of the soil will increase. As well as the cation exchange capacity of the soil will increase. So then whatever the ammonia that will be fixed will be, the ammonium fixation will be there. So volatilization loss will be minimized. Okay. So last one. So now, one is two types of fertilizer. One we are applying, one is solid, another is liquid. Okay. So if we are applying the liquid fertilizer, then whatever the chemical reactions, these are overwhelming fast. This is the quick reaction will be there. If we are applying liquid fertilizer, then reaction will be quicker, hence volatilization loss will be more. Your volatilization loss will be less. If we are applying solid fertilizer, then the reactions are occurring, these are under slow process. So volatilization loss will be less. But if we are applying liquid fertilizer, then what are the reactions? This is the fast process where volatilization loss will be more. Okay. So these are the basic things we have to remember. Whatever the volatilization loss will be there, always remember the partial pressure of the aqueous ammonia should be more than the partial pressure of the atmospheric ammonia. Okay. So now the basic thing is that these are the basic things we have already covered. What, how to minimize. Again, if you want to write in the mains paper some more reactions so that it will fetch more mark, so you just this is very easy. Whatever the ammonium ion will be released, either it will be reacted with minus, because whatever the volatilization loss will be there, this is due to the alkaline soil. So whatever the NH4 plus ion will be there, so it will react with OH minus ion. Again, it will release nitrogen gas will be released. So here, this is in case of denaturation process. So whatever the NH4 plus will be there, here it will react with OH minus, hence it will release NH3 aqueous. In volatilization loss, always remember NH3 aqueous. And what will happen? H2O will be released. In some cases, this NH4 plus, if it will react with HCO3 minus, we have already told it will release NH3 aqueous ammonia and water and carbon dioxide. Again, if this NH4 plus will react with CO3 minus 2, then it will release NH3 aqueous plus carbon dioxide. Okay. plus carbon dioxide plus water. So if you are balancing the equation, just multiply 2 here and multiply 2 here. Okay. So these are the 3 reactions by which out of the ammonical form nitrogen will be there. Either it comes from the fertilizer, ammonical form fertilizer, or it may come from the methylation process. These reactions will be there. Either it will react with hydroxide ion or bicarbonate ion or carbonate ion, so that aqueous ammonia will be formed. Okay. So these are the important things you have to remember in the validation loss process. Okay. So thank you. In the next class, we will study the denitrification process. Okay. Thank you. And I hope you are liking this chapter, and please study well, so that it will motivate me. If you are getting some knowledge from my channel and if you are utilizing these sources in your exam, then I will be definitely